Good evening, good evening, good evening, everyone. I am the rookie chef, Young Reno. And today we're going to be doing a dish playing a little bit of smooth jazz because this dish is going to be made with steak. So, you know, steak and jazz kind of go good with each other, you know. But we're going to be making some delicious Cajun New York steak sandwiches with some homemade French fries, all right? Something a little bit fun. So that's what we're going to be doing, y'all. We're going to be making it a little different tonight. You know what I mean? I decided to just do something real quick and fun and simple that anybody can do, of course. And we're also going to have steak sauce. You can use your A1, whatever steak sauce you use. That steak sauce going to go on there. Let me just introduce the ingredients right now, okay? First of all, of course, we have our green leaf lettuce. We have our tomato. We have our jalapeno. We have our habanero in there as well. You know me, I'm that spicy guy. We got a fresh red onion. We got a fresh potato that I'm going to cut up into French fries. We have a thin slice of New York steak right here. I'm going to cut the fat off on the sides, and we're going to put that in my grill skillet. We got some Southern hot mustard. Yep, got to be spicy. We got some steak sauce. We got some steak cracked pepper seasoning, Creole season, of course. And you know my kicking chicken. I still like the flavor when it's on the steak. Little onion powder, little black pepper. We got the grilling skillet here. We got the pan for the fries. All right. So with all due delay, let's get this going right now. Okay, welcome back, y'all. So what I did was I took this beautiful piece of New York steak. Beautiful piece of New York steak here. I just cleaned it. So now what we're about to do is trim off some of the fat with my trimming utensils right here, okay? So what I'm just gonna do is I'm gonna start right here. And just start taking it off like that. You know, because we don't necessarily need the fat on there. Okay? Just like that, so. You know, want to take this off. Take that fat off like that there. Now, if you want to leave just a little bit on there, just, you know, a little bit on there just to give you a little bit of that fat steak flavor, you can, but not too much. You want to get most of it. Well, me, I want to get most of it off. Some people like to cook with it. We cook with some of the fat. It ain't nothing wrong with that. With me, I like to go lean. So y'all can see what I'm doing here. I'm just taking off the ones that stuck to the skin a little bit like that there. There you go. So once we get most of that off, then you know, it's gonna be the perfect size for the sandwich. You know, so what I probably didn't say to tell y'all is we're using these right here. These buns. You know, these are some nice little buns. You know, these buns right here, they call the bello buns. I don't know if y'all heard of those, but they're real good. What we're going to do is we're going to cut one in half, put it in the conventional oven, let it toast up a little bit, put a little butter on there, then put our other little stuff on it. Y'all will see when we get there. But I just wanted to let you know because I forgot to mention the bread. All right. So, just going to get all this little fat cut off. And then what we're going to do is we're going to tenderize the meat. I got what you call a judge tenderizer. Because it looked just like a gavel, you know. So that's exactly what I'm going to do once I get this excessive fat off, okay? So like I say, this is the rookie chef way, very simple and easy. You know, you want to just, you have got a taste for a steak sandwich and don't want to go to a fast food steak sandwich, just go to your lucky grocery store. I went to Safeway and got mine. That's all you have to do. Go to your lucky grocery store, and you'll be all good to go. Now look at that. Look at that. Beautiful, huh? Got all that fat out there. Now we got a lot of meat there. Oh, wait, let me get this little part right here. Okay, that's how we do that. Now, let me clean up a little bit, and let's begin the tenderizing process. All right, y'all. So here's my judge gavel. You know, on this side, I use this side, they got the little sharp parts, that's how I tenderize. You can also use the smooth side if you want, but for myself, I like to use this part right here. And what I simply do is I just take the meat like this, and I just get that little part out. And I just do it like that. It actually stretches the steak out, makes it a lot more tender. It actually melts in your mouth. And remember, this is the rookie chef way. I mean, I'm pretty sure everybody knows you can tenderize it with this, but I learned on my own, you know. I just learned on my own and just did it and tried it, and it definitely works out well. So they definitely knew what they was talking about. And with thin cut, you don't have to do it as much. See, this is all I'm gonna do it. Sit. Look at that. Look at that. That's all I'm gonna do it, okay? So we're gonna do it like that. Let me move this out of the way. Now what we're gonna start doing is I'm gonna simply take this, put it on this white paper plate here, so we can begin the seasoning process. So what I got is, I got my Insane Steak Cracked Pepper, which is actually good on steak. You know, so we're just gonna sprinkle some of that on there like that. And then I'm just gonna rub it. Rub it and pat it in there like that. This brings out the flavor. Brings out the flavor. And you can buy this at any grocery store. You can get something close to it. Some kind of steak seasoning, you know? And when we become like the professionals later, we can make our own seasoning. But for now, we're going to do it the rookie style way, because the rookie chef way is the way how we learn. Okay, we can't forget that now. All right. So now that we got that on there, you can put this in any order. It ain't have to be in the order I'm doing it. A little onion powder. Just a little bit of onion powder. Like that. You don't want much. You know, I just say maybe a teaspoon. You know. All right. Then from that point on, you know, your cracked pepper, don't take the top off. Just a few twists and turns. It's smelling good already. And I only season one side. I don't season both sides, okay? A little bit of Creole seasoning, of course. You know, I'm just going to make this steak very flavored. I'm not putting a lot. Like I say, maybe a teaspoon, you know. You ain't got to get crazy with it. All right, just like that there. My kicking chicken. That's pretty much it. I'm not putting no salt in it because, you know, your Creole seasoning already got that, you know. And your cracked pepper seasoning got a little bit of that too. So, basically, this is how I'm doing it. So, I'm pushing those flavors in there so it doesn't come off when I put it. But see, look at that. Y'all can see them flavors on there just like that. All right? So, now that I got that going, I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to get my grill skillet to heating up. And then what we're simply going to do is start cutting down some of these vegetables, that toppings that we're going to put on this, okay? So we're going to do it like that. So I'm going to go ahead and put this in the refrigerator, let this chill for a little bit, kind of let my grill skillet get a little seasoned, because I'm going to put some canola oil on there. Even though steak makes its own meat, but when you first put it in there like this, it will start sticking a little bit. So we're going to help it out with this, okay? We'll do it like that. All right? So when I come back, we're going to keep this moving. Okay, y'all. So now let's start getting our topping set up now. So we got my onion first. So you know on my onion, I have to take that part off first. And I just like to, I cut it real thin. It's not going to be a lot of onions. You know, I don't like too many onions on sandwiches, but I do like the flavor that the red onion gives it. So I'm just going to take, y'all going to see. It's going to be just like that. Very simple and thin. That's it. That's pretty much it. That's all I'm doing right there. All right. I'm going to take the rest of my onion. And we're going to put it in this freezer bag, put it in the refrigerator, because believe it or not, it keeps it fresh and makes it last a lot longer, too. So I'm just going to stick that on up in there like that. Okay? Just like that. So, this is what I got. This is what I got, you know? And pretty much this is all I'm going to be using, you know? Just enough where I can just put the flavor on there. That's it. That's it. And I'm not even going to use all of this. So we're probably just only going to use maybe just these three right here. That's it. Just want the flavor. That's it. That's all you want is the flavor. If I have to overdo it, nothing. Okay? Y'all know the red onions can be a little powerful. Matter of fact, you know what? I'm thinking I'm going to use only two rings. Two rings. We're going to go with two rings. I just think that's necessary. So what I'm going to do, cut a little bit, make it a little bit thinner. And like I say, it's your preference how you want to do it. This is just the Rookie Chef way. I'm just cutting around the little red, you know, the little skin part. So that way it can be a lot more thinner when I get ready to put it on a sandwich. Like that. It just works for me. Kind of turns it into a white onion, but with the red onion flavor, okay? All right. So, I'm going to put that right there. You know what? What the hell? Why not? I'm going to use the other one, too. Because I'm cutting them down small, so it's okay. Just cutting that red off. Like I said, cutting that red off makes it a little bit thinner. Okay, there we go. All right. So, that's what we do there. Okay. We just go ahead and get this cleaned up for us right there. All right. Go. Okay, now go ahead and get our tomato. Got our fine little tomato here, and y'all remember how I do my tomatoes. I'm just gonna do real thin. One, two, three. And four. Only using four. That's it. That's it. Only using four. That's all I need. And you know how I cut them up? Just like this. Just like that. Okay. So go ahead and put these to the side right there. Like so. Okay. To the side right there. Okay. Next, let's do this. Well, here, what I got here is I got zesty dill pickles, slices. They got a little zest to them, little bit of a little spicy flavor. Not right, they're very mild, but you can taste it. It has a really good flavor. I love the zesty style, okay? So, yes, we are going to have the pickles. And on this one, I just take one. We only gonna use one. That's gonna go in the middle of the sandwich. And it's gonna work, you'll see. It's not gonna be too much pickly. Because again, I don't like too much pickly either, but I do like the flavor it's gonna give this steak sandwich. I do like that, all right? So let's go ahead and put that back in. And I forgot to mention that I was using that. Okay, next we're gonna use jalapenos. Y'all remember how I do my jalapeno, remember? Do them thin, two, one. Two, three, four. We're not going to use the habanero this time. I changed my mind because it's going to already have a nice little spicy taste. Because don't forget, we got this right here, the Southwest hot mustard, which is spicy itself. We're only going to use a little bit. But y'all remember, this is how I do that like that, okay? This is how I do it like that. Okay, so we got that in there. Now, green leaf lettuce, y'all. Very simple. You do not need a lot of this. So basically, what I'm just going to do is just tear off a piece. Probably like that. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to tear it down the middle like that. And now we just got two. So all we need is the two, okay? Put this back on up. Tell y'all, very simple. Now, this is what we got. Here's our toppings right there. Don't that look good? This is what we got. Lettuce, zesty dill, pickles, our tomato, our red onions, our jalapeno, all right? Simple as that. That's what we got. Now, what we about to do now is I'm going to go ahead and get this kicked up like I was telling y'all. I already got this kind of warming up. And then we're going to just keep it moving to the next step. Okay, welcome back, y'all. Now we got this potato. Let's go ahead and cut this potato on down. I cut it the long way. Y'all remember how I did my other video? I cut them the long way so they can be kind of like a steak cut, but a fancy. Not wedges, but a steak cut. So basically, let me just cut off this right there. So now we just start like this. You know, I cut them a little thick. So you're going to use the whole potato, so you're not wasting nothing. Cut them about like that thick, about that thick. One, two. Sometimes you can just do two or do three. Look, skin on, baby, skin on. We're gonna cut another one. You know, thick cut. Here we go. One, two. With this one, you can do four because it gets thicker as you get more into the potato. All right. Now, start getting a little trickier when you're trying to cut because you're getting closer to the end now. So you don't have to make them so thick when you're getting closer to the end. So you can be able to use this whole thing. This one I will do three. Y'all gonna see what I mean. And it's just you. It's just you. So just cut it in the way where it's just gonna be enough for you. Okay. Okay. Last one, because I'm not gonna use those ends. One, two, three. That's it. These ends I throw away. You pretty much got a bunch of fries. You know, look at that. Nice fries, y'all. Nice fries. And they're gonna be nice and crispy and they're gonna be good. Because we're gonna cook these just right. So I'm gonna go ahead and put them in here. So we're gonna go ahead and put them in here. Oh man, I gotta let me cut this one down. That one's really big. Okay. So now we got that right there. I'm going to go ahead and rinse these. I'm going to rinse these real quick. And then we're going to go ahead and get them up in there. Once I get them up in there, I'm going to put a little Cajun seasoning in there. A little red pepper, crushed red pepper seasoning in there. I mean grounded red pepper seasoning in there. And then some black pepper. Not going to put no salt in there. Once they're done, I'm going to just do a little sprinkle. Just a little pop, a little pinch of salt. That's it. All right. So let me go ahead. Let me go ahead and get these in that grease. And then now we're about to get this steak going. Get the steak going. We're about to get this into the conventional oven. We're almost to the finish line. You see how easy that is? Rookie chef way. Rookie chef style, y'all. You know? So I got my pan right here, y'all, for my conventional oven. What I'm simply going to do is I'm going to take this roll. And I'm going to cut it right here. I'm just going to simply cut it in half, just like that. I'm going to put them in just like that. And I'm going to put the toaster on. These are going to come out nice and crispy. You know, not crispy like toast, but they're going to be lightly toasted, and they're going to have a nice little softness to it. Then we're going to put some butter on them. We're going to start dressing these up, okay? So let me go ahead and put this in the conventional oven right now. Go ahead and get this turned on. Okay, boom. Now, we go ahead and let that cook, okay? Get some of this and set the bread off. Okay, so now, let's go ahead and take our steak out. Okay, we got that beautiful looking steak right there. Don't forget that, y'all, that beautiful looking steak right there. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn y'all over here. Let's get y'all on over here, okay? Get y'all on over here, okay? We got our grill skillet here, and then let me see if I can kind of bump y'all up a little more. Okay, we got our grill skillet here, and then we also got our pan here for the french fries, okay? So let me go ahead and, it doesn't take long for this thing to crank up. So now, we're gonna get our canola oil. Get our canola oil. A little bit of spray like that so our steak don't stick too much. That's how we want to do it, like that there. So we're gonna go ahead and let that heat up. Gonna get our potatoes. Got our french fries right here. I went on and washed them and then I patted them off. Okay, let's go ahead and start putting them in the grease. Yeah, nice. You hear that? Very nice sizzle. No grease popping because I damped the excessive water off. Okay, so that's what you want to do. Pretty sure it's going to be enough to get them all in here, I think. I'll put them in side by side. Shit, we were really, really close. Y'all make some room for y'all potato brothers. Make some room up in there. Got one more big one left. That's all right. We're just going to let that one stay right there. Okay. All right, y'all. So, we got that going. Okay, so with that, while that's frying, I'm going to go ahead and put a little pepper in that. Just a little grease while that's cooking. Put a little bit of pepper in there like that there. Okay. And as I told you before, just a little bit of Cajun seasoning in here. So it can kind of circulate in that grease while that potatoes is frying. That's pretty much all I'm going to put in there. Okay, now we're going to get the steak going. Okay, y'all, so we got those potatoes going. The bread is actually already done and toasted. So what we want to do is get on here and get this steak, nice steak in here, just like that. Okay, we're going to let that get the frying. Get my little spatulas here. We're gonna get that to frying. We got our potatoes going already. Put on a little, I don't kick a little fan on. It's gonna be too noisy. But we got everything going. So now what I'm gonna do is turn y'all back over here. Turn y'all back over here real quick. Okay. There we go. So as y'all know, these are nice. Get that toasted, right? Toasted here, real soft now. So, while it's real hot, I'm going to take my butter here. And we're just going to take a little bit of this butter. All right? Just a little bit, not too much. Okay? A little butter on there like that. Let that start melting in there a little bit. Yeah, I'm using a plastic spoon, y'all. Oh. I mean, a plastic knife. All right, okay? So put a little butter on that, on the top of that, there we go, just gonna rub it in, there we go, melting pretty good, that's what we want, look at that, that's what we want,